Today we're talking about DACA. Is something that the Supreme Court didn't say? Yes, DACA, a program operating in more of a legal gray area than the people it's protecting. Now why are we talking about DACA today? Well, because we're due for our annual DACA repeal scare. I mean, it's been 7 years. Can we stop this will they, won't they roller coaster? There are two specific DACA updates that we're covering today. First,
also today, the Supreme Court once again did not act on President Trump's administration's effort to end the Deferred Action for Childhood Arrival Program, commonly known as DACA.
The Supreme Court is refusing to hear a case being brought about the DACA program. And second, how this decisive indecision affects our shutdown fight. Because, oh man, let's just add another month to the battle. So what happened? Well, if you want to know exactly what a Supreme Court case against DACA would look like, I did an episode about United States v. Texas, in which an 8-member Scalia-less Supreme Court deferred to a lower court ruling that blocked a DACA extension and DAPA, which is DACA for adults. Biggest difference between that case and our hypothetical? Back then we were in a pre-Kavanaugh and Gorsuch court. I mention this because most people think that if you can get this in front of the Supreme Court today, at that point my money might be on that snowball in hell. So again, what is going on here? Well, this case started in 2017.
In other words, the executive branch, through DACA, deliberately sought to achieve what the legislative branch specifically refused to authorize on multiple occasions. Such an open-ended circumvention of immigration laws was an unconstitutional exercise of authority by the executive branch.
As you can imagine, lawsuits piled up against this announcement before Trump could even tweet the word DACA, and we were off to the races.
A U.S. district judge has blocked the Trump administration from rolling back DACA, at least temporarily.
Oh wow, a district court blocked something Trump wants to do. There's an outcome so unsurprising Larry King didn't even dust off the old breaking news graphic to announce it. Because of this, DACA protections for participating undocumented minors were maintained. But of course, that was not the end of the story.
The Trump administration is turning to the Supreme Court over a federal judge's ruling on DACA. The Justice Department asked the Supreme Court to review a lower court's decision blocking the White House from ending the program.
So now we're here with the Supreme Court saying, you know what, this is a bit of a hot button political issue for us. We'll just stick to transgender individuals in the military. Now the broader point of why this completely screws up Trump's shutdown plans. DACA is such a legally confusing issue because Congress has never passed a bill making DACA into law. When they rejected this DACA bill, Obama said, "I can't hear you over my high approval rating," and passed it as an executive order. And here's one constitutional scholar to explain exactly what's wrong with that picture.
There are enough laws on the books by Congress that are very clear in terms of how we have to enforce our immigration system, that for me to simply, through executive order, ignore those congressional mandates would not conform with my appropriate role as president.
What can I say? The man knows his way around the Constitution. So if the case we're talking about today was focused on the merits of DACA, it would be a done deal. Problem was, the issue being judged isn't whether DACA was implemented constitutionally, but rather whether Trump's order to remove DACA was constitutional. Now, I'll use a metaphor because honestly, I think I just confused myself there a little bit. Imagine you're playing a game of Monopoly, a game where everybody knows the rules until you get that one kid who swears it's legal to cram 5 hotels on Park Ave, because that's the way he always plays. I mean, we're pretty sure that's not the rules, but what judges would say happened next was, without looking into any of the official rule books, the Trump administration just said, "That really feels illegal, so we're not gonna play that way." Don't worry, I'll continue to break this down. I know it's complicated. This is why lawyers get paid an amount of money that makes me regret every one of my life decisions. The administration's argument for getting rid of DACA was,
"Such an open-ended circumvention of immigration laws was an unconstitutional exercise of authority by the executive branch."
It's unconstitutional. Great, game over. Only problem, we don't know for sure it's unconstitutional. Now, conservatives, I can hear some of you turning on the caps lock, cracking those knuckles, and just getting ready to go to town in the comments section. But what about United States v. Texas, the case you mentioned earlier that blocked DAPA and a DACA extension? Well, that case was a tie vote in the Supreme Court, so no legal precedent was actually set there. In fact, the entire decision was 24 words long, so you could put the entire thing on a fortune cookie with some extra space for those random lucky numbers. So how could you then say it was unconstitutional? Well, according to the court documents, Jeff Sessions said, because the DACA policy has the same legal and constitutional defects that the courts recognized as to DAPA, it is likely that potentially imminent litigation would yield similar results with respect to DACA. But yeah, man, I'm looking through a rulebook right now and it does not cover this super specific legal argument.
According to the judge's order, he's saying this has to be nationwide and that the Trump administration simply wasn't within its rights to abandon the program for legal reasons, because he said there is no proof that the order that was first issued by President Obama is illegal.
So what? Are all executive orders permanent as long as the president doesn't violate the Constitution when passing them? Well, no, but when your argument for getting rid of a regulation is literally just that it's unconstitutional, when you can't prove that it's unconstitutional, well, that might raise some eyebrows. This administration was so confident that, according to the court documents, the district court told the government to complete the paperwork required to legally overturn DACA. But instead of doing that, the Trump administration said, nah, forget that paperwork. I think the legality of overturning DACA should stand or fall based solely on that just five-star unconstitutional argument that we described earlier. As we all now know, that worked out just great, and they went all in on King High. So why is this such a problem for the shutdown? Well, as The Economist pointed out, Mr. Trump noted that if we win a DACA case with the Supreme Court, we'll easily be able to make a deal on DACA in the wall as a combination. Yeah, starting to see a problem. When you hear things like,
the proposal would offer temporary protections for so-called dreamers, or undocumented immigrants brought to the U.S. as children. It would also include more border protection for agents and other immigration officials.
Well, that three-year DACA deal is looking a lot less important, considering who is going to be taking away DACA now. It certainly won't be Congress. There aren't any cases directly questioning the constitutionality of DACA coming down the Supreme Court pipe, and this was the executive branch's attempt to get rid of DACA being blocked until their appeals get heard by the Supreme Court. I mean, without that part, the offer is, if you help us pay for the wall, we'll hire more border security agents. Sounds like a great nonpartisan deal. Now, of course, DACA isn't totally out of the woods yet, because come on, we can't just stop participating in our annual, oh my god, are we gonna get rid of DACA news extravaganza? It's tradition! The Trump administration's appeal is still pending in the courts, so it could get a talking up by the Supreme Court during their next few terms. But there's definitely a lot less urgency. Before I go, I want to, one last time, explain what this case was, because it's being misrepresented by some in the media.
And I talk also DACA, but I just think that we're better off waiting for the Supreme Court. If the Supreme Court rules that President Obama was wrong, which they should, because, by the way, if he was right, then I've been given tremendous power. Can you imagine me having that power? Wouldn't that be scary? Right?
Well, I guess that would be scary, although that joke is only funny based on the assumption that you're completely irresponsible with power. Someone doesn't understand what this case is about though, because one final time, this case is not a referendum on DACA. If this was about DACA's implementation being constitutional or not, I would bet my life savings against DACA's survival. This case is about saying you're gonna remove an executive action from the books, and saying the only reason you're doing it is because it's unconstitutional, and then not being able to point to any legal precedent to show it's unconstitutional. I mean, that was really just a dumb thing to do. Just say you're doing it for the economy or something. That works on environmental protections. Anyways, because of this, the executive branch's ability to get rid of this program is held up in the court system. So I'll be curious to see what President Trump will be able to offer the Democrats next. In exchange for the wall, we'll give Nancy Pelosi 10 seconds in a money booth with my tax returns and classified Mueller documents. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, non-partisan comedy news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head. Or do it the old-fashioned way by clicking that subscribe button below. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and remember to give me a thumbs up if you liked what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.